everyone, it's Ms. Dye, Ms. Jennifer, and Ms. Cook. And we're back with an update for our 30-day challenge. I hope you guys did the challenge with us. And today we're just going to talk a little bit about our update about how we did. Did we do good? Did we miss out on something? Who knows? Let's find out. We're going to start with Ms. Jennifer. And let us know, how did you do with the challenge? So we had 30 days of Meatless Mondays, Sugarless Tuesdays, water with your meals on Wednesdays, exercising, gratitude. How did you do?
I did pretty well. The first couple days, those Meatless Mondays, and those Sugarless Tuesdays, and those Only Water Wednesdays kind of got the best of me sometimes, but... like after the first week, it wasn't as bad as I thought it was gonna be. I'm like, oh, what's a lot of stuff you eat that doesn't have meat in it? It's a lot of stuff that doesn't have as much sugar as you think in it. The water thing definitely helped. I could see my water intake go up. I started doing like the stretching in the morning before I would come to work, so I could feel the difference in my body. I felt like my day kind of even went better in a sense, with the waking up and stretching and stuff. The exercise thing, I really did do good with that this month, but it was hard to kind of try to keep up with my steps more this month. Like me and Ms. Cook were talking about like the home exercises, yes, with the, like books and pillows and stuff. I actually got like some little stretch weight bands and stuff.
Oh, yeah.
This is it. I was feeling it this month, guys. Really can tell the difference. The no soda thing was probably the hardest thing for me because I love me some Pepsi, but I have not drank no soda.
Oh, that's
awesome. I haven't
drank
any soda. I drink like juice maybe once or twice a week, like towards the end of the week, but I really don't drink as much. I don't drink soda as all often. I don't drink soda at all, but I don't drink as much juice or anything anymore for sure.
Good.
So I feel good.
That's
I feel
good.
It. I'm ready. I feel like I can kind of keep it going past the 30 days, so, you know, start some new habits and break some old ones. So I really do feel good about this challenge. I think I did well with it. Probably, but I could have did better, but I think I did well with it. I could see the differences and I could feel the differences, so.
That's good.
That is awesome. You guys, an awesome testimonial. Let's see how Ms. Cook did with her challenge.
Well, I did pretty good when it came to the meatless. Mondays, I found different things to cook, spaghetti squash, mushrooms, just doing different things. Sugarless Tuesdays was a little difficult because everything has sugar in it, but I did my best. I stretched in the morning and I did line dancing. And I end up pulling a muscle.
Oh no!
Don't ask me how I did that, okay? So I'm walking around here half crippled up. I wasn't able to exercise the way I really wanted to because I had to, you know, get that muscle back in shape. You know, other than that it's always like that. Whenever you get ready to try to do something, you know, then something happens like that. But I didn't let that stop me with all the other stuff.
Okay.
So I did I was constantly being thankful and grateful.
Yeah.
But I still need to work on the exercise. So I said I'm gonna do some yoga or something that's really where I'm moving slow and stretching.
Tai Chi.
Right. So other than that, I would like to continue to do it. I really would like to continue because this let me know that I can go without meat, that I can go without, you know, sugar, you know, so I would like to continue the challenge.
Oh my goodness, what a great testimonial, Ms. Cook. This is so awesome. Okay, everyone, for me, I'm going to start off with a little transparency. I suffered when it came down to the exercise workout, you guys. And you guys know I'm an outdoor type of girl. I love to get out there and hike. And I did not do anything. I actually went to YouTube and I found some awesome cardio videos that I put into a little file folder. And I never went to it. So with the exercise, you guys, I did not do good. I can't even give myself one star on that one. But as far as the Meatless Mondays, I did terrific. Like Miss Cook, I actually prepared spaghetti squash. I actually made some stuffed eggplant, and I also made some stuffed sweet potatoes, and it was very delicious. And I found out for me, what helped me to get through that challenge was to be prepared ahead of time, to have recipes that I had researched, and that helped me to stick to the plan on the Meatless Mondays. As far as the Sugarless Tuesdays, I did a phenomenal job with that as well. With the water, I'll say I did pretty fair. I did drink at least, I'll say 3 bottles of water, which is fair. I could have did more, but that was a great start for me. As far as soda, I've never been a type of soda girl. I've been more of a juice type of girl, where I juice my fresh fruits and juice my fresh vegetables. So I did good with the veggies on that part. With the veggies, I actually ate a lot of salads. I actually ate a lot of raw vegetables, which was very nutritious and delicious as well. And then with the encouragement, I did a phenomenal job. I love to journal, so I kept up with my journaling every day and always wrote something positive or self-confirming about myself. So that is my testimonial, you guys. And we would like to encourage you to continue on with the 30-day challenge, okay? Just a reminder, it's 30 days of Meatless Mondays, no meats. 30 days of Sugarless Tuesdays, no processed sugar. 30 days of water only on Wednesdays with your meal. And there is 30 days of stretching every morning. 30 days of no soda. 30 days of no smoking. 30 days of gratitude. 30 days of exercise, workout, any kind. 30 days of eating your veggies. And 30 days of positive exchange with your family, your friends, your neighbors, our coworkers. We know that you can do it because we get through it, and so can you, okay? Yes. So don't only hold this 30-day challenge for yourself. Be sure to tell your family and friends as well.